All right, the gates were open, and we are in the Angeles National Forest now. So I drive up a bit. I don't have much gas, but we'll pick a nice spot and check things out. It's a little traffic here on the way up. We're at the base of the mountain here. See how much is open. Did have fires in the area recently, so be very careful with this traffic too. The people actually race down this thing, up and down. All right, let's head further up. It's a nice night for sky watching too. It's pretty clear. And we got a few pieces of gear with us. Check it out with that stuff as well. Check things out here. Right, we are further up on the mountain. It's a pretty fatal drop off there if you go off the side here. Anyway, that's a view of the ridges. We're a little further up on the mountain. You can hear some hooting there. Sounds like an owl. Do have the road right behind us though. Looks like some garbage there. But I think it's a good spot. Try to listen for anything weird and see anything strange in the sky. So get the gear out now. Can hear some hoots in the background there. Using this necklace device thing to hold my phone. It's facing me right now. See the moon in the background. And this is cool because I'm able to hold two other devices with my two other hands. So I'll be holding my night vision and my thermal. So let's test that out. So any footage you see now tonight will be from this device. Like I said, I'll be using other gadgets, but still getting used to this. It's got these little stabilizer things that tie around the It's got a strap around the waist, and I could adjust it too. It's pretty cool. Alright, I'm gonna try this from the chest here. I was gonna take the phone off. So I wanted to mention also this neck device required me to put this ring on the back of my case. So it's a magnet and it sticks to this little arm that also has a magnet. So it's a little tough to take off, but I'm starting to notice this orb of, looks like an orb of light. Right there. See that? That's like, I would say, well, you can see there where on the mountain it is. And there's no people over there. And I also noticed there might be a couple more. So we'll pan around here. See if we spot them. I thought I spotted one way down there. But this one tends to be brightening up and then it'll dim down again. Just like I used to see on the old property. Fully zoomed in there. The audio recorder going. That little extension on it. I'm on a berm type thing here. Truck, my gear set up here, and it will be traffic going by. It's a lot of traffic. Some of them have been going real fast. Some of these guys, like I said, race up here, so it's pretty scary. We'll see if we could get any of that on video. But yeah, we'll be focusing on this light object over here. Sounds like someone got a flat. Did you hear that? He just got out. Looks like he's checking. Drops pretty far down. If you remember, where was it? It's probably a little further up the road. I got some, there's a lot of rescues. There's actually a guy missing over by Mount Wilson, which is a few few miles further up. So goes the tow truck. It's about maybe 10 miles further up, I think. Not too far up. But if you go to, what is it, Brian's Mysteries on the Trail on YouTube, and it's a Angeles National Forest missing case. And the guy came up here hiking and They ain't never found him.
Alright, that orb of light is starting to pop up again. Got really bright. Earlier, I thought it was some buoys for the airplane. But it just got really bright.
Zooming out to see if you can see it from here. Sorry, I'm doing this from the neck device. They're winked out. And I honestly don't think it's anyone hiking down there. Because it's not completely at the bottom. And down there, there's a pretty big creek or river. And that light popped up in the same area too earlier. I thought it was, I don't think my phone could pick it up, but there's these, like I said, buoy type things hanging on like these lines, and that's for aircraft. And I'm starting to see some of those little orbs pop up in different places. There seems to be one way down there. I don't know if the camera's picking it up. Let's see. Try to get it. Super interesting. Got someone pulling up here. All right, there goes that light right there. And I do see power lines in the way. Excuse me. I do see power lines in the way. So I don't know if it's something that has to do with those airplane buoys that I'm talking about. But this thing looks super bright. It tends to fade out. I haven't really seen it move too much from there either. See that? Mosquitoes. Excuse me.
That was interesting. Sounded like from across the way there. A lot of rescues and stuff happen here, I was mentioning. And I think recently two cars went over. It's Highway 2. Angeles National Forest. So it's people off to the right. Hearing some sounds off of that way. Text message. I got actually one or two bars here. I was texting my nephew, let him know where I'm at, actually, that I have service here. Moon super bright. Light hasn't turned back on. There goes Orion. Not sure what that was. Probably a bug or something. Oh. Phone neck strap fell. Gotta tie this back on. Luckily I had these, little safety straps on there. getting this strange light from down in that area. Got some footage with the phone, and that I heard something. That's probably a car. There's a lot of traffic around. I'm trying to figure out that little light mystery. It hasn't popped back up. I've waited about 15, 20 minutes since all that happened. So it happened twice where I recorded. I've been up here maybe a couple hours now. It's a little, probably sometime past midnight. It's one of those buoy things again. Just hang right there. But this other light was something else. And I had a feeling today. I told the Latchkey Hustle. Seen him in the chat over on SOR. And told him I was going to head up this way. Just had a feeling. Something told me to come up here. And I think this light thing was pretty strange. And I want to go back and listen to those, what I thought were some sort of vocals. Had a couple people pull up here. On this pull out. Got some ridges pretty much all around us here. It drops down into a canyon down there. City lights over there. I'm not too far in. Just focusing on these power lines up here too. So there's also power lines going through here. Through up there and all through down here. That's why I was thinking maybe that light was like some sort of beacon for like what these buoy things do during the day. Because I believe those things are to let aircraft know not to go, I guess, below a certain height is what I'm thinking those things are for. Maybe someone could correct this if we're wrong. I didn't go much further up just because of gas. We'll see how much gas we have left over when we get back down the mountain. There's been a whole lot I could go on about this area. I'd like to go on and do some things on it, go to actual locations and stuff, but I'll have to mark this pullout here. We'll wait a little longer and see if that happens again. Looks like a little shooting star went by there. Missed one right before that. Like a bird or
get a knock sound if anyone's around. Did request a little knocking sound earlier. Sounded like something there.